that pseudocode asked us to let I go from 0 to the length over 2 minus 1. That minus 1 is always a little inelegant. I prefer to use the less than sign here. Inside the loop, we were supposed to swap the position I and I plus length over 2. Let's copy and paste the swap code. Here it is. But now j, of course, is supposed to be this. Now I've fixed up the code, and I'm ready to run. Here you see the result, the array before and after swapping. And you can see that these numbers are now where they're supposed to be, as well as for the other half. I want to briefly talk about the code that produced this printout here. When you look over here, we call system.out.println, and we can't directly print elements. As I said, arrays are more primitive than array lists, and an array will not print out its value. This method here takes an array and turns it into a string that lists all of the values inside. So when you want to print out an array list, you can directly pass it on to system.out.println. When you have an array, you have to use this helper method. Of course, you could also use a direct loop, but the helper method is more convenient. Now remember what the point of all of this was. The point was not how to implement the swapping algorithm in Java. The exciting thing was how we discovered it in the first place. We discovered it by playing around with stuff and not by worrying about exactly how the index values were or whether we needed a for loop or a while loop. And I hope that's the lesson that stays with you. If you need to do something that's off the beaten track, that's different from what you've seen before, get out some Lego bricks, some coins, some candies, whatever, and figure out what the operation would be with those. And that'll give you the intuition that you need in order to be a successful programmer. Programming is all about having the right ideas and the right intuition, not about pushing the symbols of the programming language around.